Hello students, we have gone through the entire chapter of forest and wildlife. In today's session, we will discuss the doubts of the chapter that you have mailed. The topics are rare species, endemic species, classification of forests, Asiatic cheetah, Himalayan yew. After that, we will discuss some important questions from examination point of view. One important thing is that this chapter is excluded from the syllabus of board examination, but it will be assessed through periodic tests. Its marks will be added in your board exam result. Now, we will go through the topics where you have doubts. First is that rare species. Rare species are the species with a small population may move into the endangered or vulnerable category if the negative factors affecting them continue to operate. They may either come into the category of endangered or vulnerable because their population is small. If negative factors are affecting on them continuously, such as hunting, poaching, deforestation, forest fire, etc., is affecting on them, then their population may decline and they may come into the category of endangered or vulnerable. So these species of plants and animals are called rare species. Their population is very small also. Examples of such species are the Himalayan brown bear, wild Asiatic buffalo, desert fox, and hornbill, etc. Now, your next doubt is about endemic species. What is endemic species? These are the species which are only found in some particular areas only. These species are not seen everywhere. These species are isolated by natural or geographical barriers. So these species are endemic. These species belong to a particular region only. Example, the Andaman tea, Nicobar pigeon, Andaman wild pig, Mithun in Arunachal Pradesh. So from its example, it is very clear that these species are found in that regions only, not all over the country. Next doubt is about classification of forests. Yes, we discussed about classification of forests into three categories. The government of India classified the forests into three categories. That is, reserved forest, protected forest, and unclassed forest. Do you know, children? In India, more than 50% of Indian forests are declared as reserved forests. These forests are permanent forests. Why did the government of India declare these forests are reserved? Because these forests are protected or keeping under the observation of Forest Department for commercial purposes, for getting timber from it. The villagers or the forest people are not allowed to enter into these forests. They are not allowed to take any kind of forest resources. These forests are totally protected by the government of India through Forest Department. Do you know where these forests are found in India? Yes, these forests are found in Jammu and Kashmir, Madhya Pradesh, Kerala, Uttarakhand, etc. This is about reserved forests. I think this topic may be clear to you now. Second is that protected forests. Protected forests are those forests which are declared by the forest department. That is, one third of Indian forest land is considered or declared as protected forest. These forests are protected from any further depletion. These forests are allowed for villagers with some conditions. Villagers can enter and collect forest resources from these forests with some conditions or restrictions only. Because these forests are protected by the forest department from any further depletion. Where are these forests found in India? These forests are found in Bihar, Haryana, Punjab, etc. Now, the third category of forest classification is that unclassed forest. This is not classified. This is unclassed. These forests are not classified either as reserved forest or protected forest. These forests are found in northeastern states and some parts of Gujarat. Now, the next topic is about Asiatic cheetah. Asiatic cheetah is the world's fastest land mammal. It belongs to the family of cat. This species can move at a speed of 112 km per hour. But unfortunately, this species is facing extinction due to decline of their habitat and prey. From 1952 onwards, India has declared this species as extinct. And almost this species is extinct from the planet. This is about Asiatic cheetah, the world's fastest land mammal. It can move at a speed of 112 km per hour. Some days it is mistaken as leopard. Asiatic cheetah, fastest world's land mammal. Next is about the Himalayan yew. Himalayan yew, that is a medicinal plant found in Himachal Pradesh and Arunachal Pradesh. A chemical compound called taxol is extracted from the bark, needles, sticks, and roots of this tree. Some chemical compound is made from the bark, sticks, needles of this tree, can be used to cure some cancers. But unfortunately, due to its over-exploitation, this plant species is also facing the threat of extinction. In some regions of Himachal Pradesh and Arunachal Pradesh, thousands of Himalayan yew have dried up. So, because of over-exploitation of any kind of species, may face the problem of extinction or they may come into the category of endangered. So these are your doubts which you have mailed to me. Now we will discuss some important questions from examination point of view. Please listen to the questions and its answers. That is very important for your examination. First question is that three adverse effects of destruction of forest and wildlife. Do you know that? Effects of destruction of forest and wildlife are negatively affect on environment. What are its effects? First is that destruction of forest and wildlife leads to disturbances in ecological balance of the environment. So it affects on ecological balance negatively. It also affects the cultural loss of communities and their displacement. You know that the communities of village areas, they depend on forest for their livelihood. If forest and wildlife is disturbed due to human activities that affect on their cultural life, they will face the problem of loss of livelihood. They may have to suffer a lot for getting such a livelihood. That may affect on their health as well as negligence of their family and the children. And loss of wildlife disturbs food chain, ecosystem and development of the society. So there is a need to protect wildlife and forest. These are the three main points describes about the effects of destruction of forest and wildlife, isn't it? Okay. Now move to second question. Please listen to the second question. Three reasons why we need to save the biodiversity of our planet. Why do we need to save the biodiversity? You know what is biodiversity? There is an interdependence and integration of all plants and animals. That is biodiversity. There is a close integration of plants and animals. There is an interdependency between plants and animals. That is biodiversity. So we need to save it. Why we need to save it? Why we need to conserve it? Because forests are not saved. Suppose forests are not saved, all wildlife will be under threat. Wildlife forms an important part of food cycle, which will be disturbed. Second point is that biological loss is directly correlated with the loss of cultural diversity. Already I mentioned in the last question is that how biological diversity or how the protection of forest and wildlife affects the cultural life of forest people. So, because of the loss of biological diversity, many of the forest people may be marginalized and also be impoverished due to loss of forest resources. Women are most affected by loss of biodiversity. Women are most affected by loss of biodiversity. As in many societies, they collect food and fuel, fodder, water, etc. If forest resources are depleted from their neighborhood areas, what happens? Their food and fuel, fodder, water, etc. will be destroyed. So they have to go to far off places for collecting such things, and that will negatively affect on their health as well as negligence of family and their children. So there is a need to protect biodiversity, to protect the life of tribal communities, because they are very closely attached with environment. They protect forest of that area, and they treat or they see forest are their as their god also. Spirituality is also connected with the biodiversity for them. Next question is that is the third question. Explain the factors for the decline of India's biodiversity. Why biodiversity is declined? Why people are declining it? What are the reasons? You know that agricultural expansion, expanding cultivation because of increasing demand of population or overpopulation, that demands more food, that prompt to expand more agricultural areas, that leads to destruction of forests, clearing of forests and convert into agricultural land. Second is that shifting cultivation. Shifting cultivation is already banned from India, but still it is practiced in northeastern parts of India. Do you know, children, what is shifting cultivation? Felling of trees and clearing the land for cultivation. So shifting of cultivation leads to deforestation. Second point is shifting cultivation. The third reason is that development projects like dams and infrastructural projects also led to the loss of forest. You know, dams, construction of big dams and infrastructural projects like railways, then highways. These projects also led to deforestation. So that projects submerged large hectares of areas of forest underwater. That also led to decline of biodiversity. Now the next point is that habitat destruction for developmental projects or for industry or for agriculture, hunting and poaching of animals, overexploitation of resources, environmental pollution and forest fires are the major threats to biodiversity. So these are the factors responsible for the depletion of the forest in India. Please listen to the points. I am repeating the points here. Factors responsible for the depletion of the forest in India are, please note down, agricultural expansion, shifting cultivation, development projects like dams and infrastructural projects, habitat destruction, hunting, poaching, overexploitation, environmental pollution, and forest fires. Is it clear to all of you? Yes. Next question. Distinguish between rare species and endemic species. Already I explained the differences between endemic and rare species. Rare species have a small population, can be grouped into endangered or vulnerable species. If the negative factors affecting them continue to exist, what are the negative factors? Always we are saying negative factors, negative factors. What is it? Negative factors are deforestation, hunting, poaching, poison, then forest fire, etc. Means over-exploitation of resources, habitat destruction, all are coming under negative factors. If negative factors are continued to operate, What will happen? This is small population of species will come either in the group of endangered or in vulnerable groups. Examples of such species are Asiatic buffalo and Himalayan brown bear. Is it clear? Okay. Next, endemic species. Endemic species are only found in certain areas. That is not found everywhere. That is found only in certain areas which are totally isolated, totally separated. Isolation word is very clear to you, familiar to you. Nowadays, you know, isolated by geographical or natural barriers. Means that areas are totally separated from other areas. So, these species are seen in that areas only, not everywhere. Example, Nicobar pigeon, Mithun in Arunachal Pradesh, etc. Next question is that, classify forests of India. Indian forests are classified as reserved forests, protected forests, unclassed forests. Reserved forests are the most valuable forests for their timber and other forest products. These forests are permanent forests. More than half of the total forest land in India falls under this category. How much? More than 50% of the total forest land is fall in the category of reserved forests. These forests are found in Madhya Pradesh, Jammu and Kashmir, Andhra Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, West Bengal, Maharashtra. Here, villagers are not allowed to enter in these forests. Villagers are not allowed to enter in these forests. These forests are protected by the government of India for collecting valuable timber. This is reserved forest. You write these points for this part, reserved forest. 4 or 5 points about a reserved forest. Second is protected forest. Protected forest here, 1/3 of the Indian forest land is classified as protected forest. These forests are found in Bihar, Haryana, Punjab, Himachal Pradesh, Odisha, Rajasthan. These forests are protected by the forest department from further depletion. Now the third category is unclassed forests. These are the forests and wastelands belonging to both government, private individuals and the communities. Who owns these forests? These forests are owned by government, private individuals and the community. All northeastern states and parts of Gujarat have large percentage of unclassed forests. These forests are not classified as reserved or protected forests. Next question is that, this is the last question, important question from this chapter, that is the salient features of Joint Forest Management Program, JFM, Joint Forest Management Program. The main features of JFM program are, number one, this is a good example of how local communities were involved in the management and restoration of degraded forests. Here, local people are largely involved in the protection of these forests with the help of government. The program has been in existence since 1988. Since 1988, this program has been come into operation. Third is that the state of Odisha first passed the resolution for joint forest management. The state of Odisha passed the resolution for this joint forest management. This is largely seen in that state. Next important feature is that JFM depends on the formation of local institutions that undertake protection activities mostly on degraded forest land managed by forest department. Means with the help of local institutions, government of Odisha supervising the protection of forest, and forest people are getting reward for this also. Last feature is that the members of these communities, those who are in that local institutions taking care of forests, are entitled to intermediary benefits. Means these people, forest people who are the member of local institutions taking care of forests, getting benefits from the government like non-timber forest products and share in the timber harvest. They get a share in timber harvest as well as they can collect non-timber forest products by their successful protection. So both forest department as well as local communities get benefit through their collective participation for protecting forests. So this is a joint venture for protecting the forest. Largely, villagers are involved in this program. They are helping the government to protect forests in their own way. So these are the important questions from this chapter that we discussed clearly. If there is any more doubt from this chapter, you can mail and that will be cleared in the next session. That's all in today's class.